Hey, welcome to the shop. So we're gonna cut up some quarter inch thick steel plate with circular saws today. Now, when I was learning fabrication, I didn't even consider circular saw as a tool for cutting metal. I always thought of that for 2x4s and plywood. Anyway, I wanted to look into it for cutting some flat plates. So I picked up this Evolution metal cutting circular saw. Now, this isn't sponsored by any of these companies. It's just some tools that I've picked up recently. This is built for cutting steel, and it comes with a blade, a steel cutting blade, and it has a gearbox in it, so it'll run a bit slower than other saws. This saw runs at 3,700 RPM compared with a typical circular saw where you're looking 4,500 to 5,500 RPM. The other saw I'm gonna look at is a hand-me-down Black & Decker. It's over 20 years old, and I picked up a dedicated steel cutting blade for it. This one is a Diablo, and I double-checked the RPM. This can handle 5,800 RPM, this blade, where the saw runs at 5,300 RPM. So that's something to always check. Make sure you never exceed the rated speed of any blade. And that goes on grinders and chop saws because they aren't all rated for the top speed that any equipment they'll fit on will run. So double check it for sure. You know, I'm always a little bit nervous about any kind of kickback or anything like that. So I'm gonna make sure my workpiece is clamped in place and it's good and solid, and that I have a good grip on the saw on both handles. I'm not gonna one hand cut this. So let's cut through this rectangular tubing here. It's a 16 gauge, a 1.5 millimeter wall thickness. And I'll go ahead and cut through with the Evolution here, and you can see it tackles that no problem at all. Now let's try it with the Black & Decker, and once again, it got through it without any issues. So they both worked great for cutting something like that. Let's move on to some quarter inch thick steel plate. And that's really what I picked this up for, is to have a good option to cut material right around an eighth of an inch to a quarter inch thick. Now I'll start with the Evolution saw. And I've started back here at the edge, and I'm moving my way in. You can see it's cutting along at a pretty good rate for getting through this quarter inch steel and not really having any issues or bogging down at all. Of course, the cut's only gonna be about as straight as I can hold it, and it would be better if I used a guide, which it comes with, or scribed a line, but this'll be okay for today. Now, let's compare that here with the Black & Decker running this blade. You can see as I cut through here, there are just a lot more sparks, or those chips coming off are just a lot hotter. I assume because of that higher blade speed, and perhaps it's getting a little bit smaller chip because there's more teeth on the blade. But either way, it's moving through at a pretty good rate. I can feel the saw bogging down a little bit. I'm not able to, you know, move through it with quite the same force that I can with the Evolution. And different saws, you know, worm drive saws or other saws may be better or worse, but anyway, you can feel that it's not really made for it. The other thing to notice is these chips that come off here, they're just a mess. They get all over the place, and there's no way around that with either of these saws, I would say that the Evolution saw contained it a little bit better. Now, which one is better? It's no surprise that I think the Evolution, that was designed for steel cutting, is a better option. And the other thing that I would assume is that it was designed with bearings and things to handle the loads of cutting steel. So I imagine the Evolution's gonna outlast, you know, just a typical saw if you're using it for cutting metal a lot. That being said, if you already have a circular saw and you're only gonna be doing a little bit of cutting, I mean, this option worked pretty well. So I don't know that there's just one right answer here, but you know, I think for the price, they both have their merits. Thanks for tuning in, and we'll see you next time.